by coincidence, the Telegraph in Britain and the Wall Street Journal in the United States both have articles in the last week about what is happening to doctors in both countries, the United Kingdom and the United States. First, the Wall Street Journal. According to a recently released survey of 613 doctors taken by the Deloitte Center for Health Solutions, 57% of U.S. doctors believe the future of the medical profession is in jeopardy. That's quotes, their own words, in jeopardy, as it, quote, loses clinical autonomy, unquote, and income. It is part of what Deloitte calls a new normal in the wake of Obamacare changes that put downward pressure, you hear that? That means, well, I think you all know what it means, on doctors' compensation, and make it harder for them to run their own practices. Half of all respondents and 68% of solo physicians say they, quote, expect their incomes to fall dramatically in the next 1 to 3 years. 6 in 10 doctors in the survey also say many of their peers are planning to retire earlier than expected. Nor are the doctors especially optimistic that the profession will continue to attract top talent. Nearly 3/4 of all physicians and 81% of surgeons said they believe the best and the brightest may not consider a career in medicine. That's up from 69% last year. That's hardly shocking as take-home pay falls, Medicaid expansion kicks into gear, and other Obamacare provisions push doctors into hospital-owned, accountable care organizations. This was classic leftism. Because there is a problem for a relatively small number of Americans, and it is the number of Americans who wanted health insurance but didn't have, was a small percentage of Americans, perhaps 5%. To fix for 5%, you ruin what has existed. This is the way it works. You blow up the institution for the sake of a small number. You blow up the definition of marriage, and that's what's happening because of compassion and concern for a far smaller percentage of Americans than the other. I would say we're talking about perhaps a half of 1%. 3% of Americans, by general agreement, are gay, and it is hard to believe that all of them, well, not all of them, that half of them, probably 1 in 10 are marrying if marriage were available, which would make it less than 1% of the American people. So you blow up the only definition marriage has ever had in terms of gender. The only one is always, it's always been male-female. You blow it up. You blow up health care in America for the sake of a small percentage. You blow up boys' rooms and girls' rooms in Massachusetts because of an infinitesimally small percentage of kids who say that they are the other sex. So children can determine which restroom they enter as of a few weeks ago in Massachusetts. That's what the left does. It's because it's a utopian movement. It must be perfect for all, or you blow it up to make it perfect for all, which is why the president said that in 5 days we will fundamentally transform the United States of America, which indeed he is doing, because not because he is a bad man, but because he is a leftist man. And leftist men.
History is made when a leader steps up, stays true to his values, and charts a fundamentally different course for the country.
That's what he has done, a fundamentally different course. It's called the left-wing course. Now the article from the Telegraph in Britain, another egalitarian ruination of something. In the name of egalitarianism, it was very important for half of medical school students to be women. After all, it's not right. So for the sake of a very small percentage of Americans, again, namely women who wish to be doctors, we are now blowing up the medical profession. Why? Not because they're less talented. In no way are they less talented. Has nothing to do with talent or excellence or anything like that. Has to do with desire to work a certain number of hours. So there is a report from The Telegraph in Britain. We already had this, believe it or not, unbelievably, in an article in the New York Times about a year ago, which I will bring to your attention once again. But here is from The Telegraph in Britain. Hilary Devey, self-made businesswoman, star of Dragon's Den and wearer of shoulder pads that would put, well, it doesn't matter, risked the wrath of women everywhere last week. She's a very big figure in British, on the BBC and in British television and in British business. She claimed in an interview that the glass ceiling does not exist and that women were not on the boards of big companies for the simple reason that they chose to prioritize having a family. So, of course, she was called a sexist and all of that. So then this led them at the Telegraph to write about women in medicine in the UK. The structure of the medical workforce is changing fast. Last weekend, I, that's Max Pemberton, the author, attended the graduation ball at Bristol University Medical School. 60% of those graduating were women. Other medical schools have an even higher percentage of female students. At the moment, just over half of registered doctors are men, but it is predicted that women will overtake them in less than 5 years. When we come back, I will tell you what that means for medicine. And it is not good, not because women are any less effective individually in terms of capability, but because they simply desire to work fewer hours. You are listening to The Dennis Prager Show. So here are the data. Dennis Prager here. Here are the data regarding British doctors. At the moment, just over half of registered doctors are men, but within less than 5 years, women will overtake them. Now, a 15-year follow-up of doctors after graduation showed that on average, after career breaks and part-time working are taken into account, women work 25% less than their male counterparts. This problem, The Telegraph in Britain writes, is not unique to the UK. In the US, Canada, across Europe, and in Japan, more women are becoming doctors, but there has been a similar failure to plan for the increase in part-time work. As a result, there is a shortage of doctors. Listen to this statistic. The problem is starting to affect both hospitals and primary care. Some 38% of female consultants work part-time compared to, and I want you to think of a number now, 38% of female consultants in hospitals and primary care work part-time compared to what percent of the men? 5%. If the majority of medical graduates are women, then, I mean, this is obviously British English, then specialisms that are not traditional family-friendly due to the antisocial hours and on-call requirements, such as acute medicine, neurosurgery, orthopedics, pediatric surgery, will be hard to fill. If women work 25% less, that means there are 25% fewer doctors. It's the same thing, right? Think about it. If it's 50-50 and women work 25% less, that's like 25% fewer doctors. Or 12.5% is whatever it would work. I don't know how the math. If it's only 50, I guess if it's all women and they work 25, then it's 25. So if it's half women, then it's over. We've lost more than one out of every 10 doctors. And worse, we have fewer doctors in certain specialties that demand a more like a 24/7 experience. Plus, when you take in what the Wall Street Journal was reporting, with fewer doctors and fewer talented people of either sex entering because the bureaucracy now is so great and the remuneration is getting smaller and smaller thanks to left-wing practices and Obamacare, that is your future. What will it end up? what they dream for, single payer.